あのさ、好きだ。
For this project, I was mostly inspired by the art style of Overwatch and Heroes of the Storm. It's a very colorful style, it has nice silhouettes, and overall I think it just looks very good. Silhouettes are super important, especially when you're doing stylized characters. They give information to your viewer about your character's story, their role, maybe even some mechanics they could have. Even with no colors or texture, you can already see how different these two characters are. You're not gonna confuse the one on the left with the one on the right. Comparing both characters, we can see the one on the left is meant to be a speedy character. They have long legs and a skinny frame, while the one on the right looks bulkier and slower, but also stronger. You might not realize it, but when you look at a shape, your brain tends to associate it with attributes or feelings. Now, these are just a few examples, but there's a bunch more, but it can really help when you're designing to know what kind of shape evokes what kind of feeling. So when you look at the female form, some of the features or traits that you'll see are large eyes, soft faces, smaller noses, long legs, narrow shoulders and waist, but very large hips. And if you look at the male form, you'll usually have harsher traits in the face. They'll have a square jaw, a more pronounced brow. They'll have broad shoulders and broad back, narrow waist and narrow hips. Just overall more muscle mass. Now, these traits are not set in stone. There's nothing preventing you from picking more masculine traits and then adding them to a female character. I think a good example of that is Zarya. She still has feminine traits, but then if you look at her jaw, she has a way more pronounced and defined jawline. Bending and twisting these expectations can make for a really interesting character, so don't be scared to experiment. The big thing you want to remember when you do stylized art is to exaggerate your proportions and your features. Apart from exaggerating your proportions, other elements that you'll want to add to your designs. Number one, putting bevels on your hard surface pieces and making sure they're large enough that they can be seen from a distance without being zoomed in. So if we look at this image, for example, right here is a really great example. It helps making a nicer silhouette and it's visible and you don't have to zoom in. If you have to zoom in, either don't put a bevel or really make it larger. Number two, panel lines. This is mostly for sci-fi and more modern designs, but it really makes a nice little detail. We have a good example on this piece right here. It can also be used to make a material transition. So this could be metal and then here some kind of fabric or a non-metallic material. And then number three is adding trims. We have a couple of examples in this image. For example, right here on the shoulder armor, you have a different transition that are helped by having a trim-like piece in between. And another one is on the pants. It really helps once again to have nice material transition and making it easier to differentiate each pieces from each other, so like the top layer from the underneath layer. You also want to make sure to have areas on your character where the viewer can rest their eyes. You don't want them to always look at something that's incredibly busy. If we look at the pants, you have lines and folds and little details and everything. And then when your eye shifts over here, you have a larger surface that has barely any details, and you have to keep a nice balance between busy areas and areas of rest.